Hello and welcome to another video here on Channel Fireball with me, Arne Huschenbeth. This time, as you can already see, without a webcam. I am on vacation right now with my family in the mountains and with my laptop, the webcam and the lighting, everything's not so perfect. So yeah, we gotta do without my face for this one. In any case, guys, it's a spicy one today. We're playing Red Green Ponza in standard. Standard rotation is coming somewhat soon. We have Dominaria United on the horizon. And before we leave Zendikar Rising and the other sets, Kaldheim and Strixhaven and so on, Adventures of the Forgotten Realm, I wanted to go ahead and try a deck that is definitely off the beaten path. Red Green Ponza in standard. It's a little bit of a brew of mine that I worked on for the last couple of days, and we are going to miss Cleansing Wildfire very much, very soon. So here I am giving it one last hooray. Yeah, so what is this deck trying to do? It's basically a red control deck with some of the best green cards to outmuscle anyone in the mid to late game. With Shigeki, we have early ramp, but also late game card advantage. With Chariot, we have one of the best mid-range cards in the format. And then Titan of Industry, just to lock things up. And combine those with some early removal here with a Braid and Flame Dust Bolt. And then we have Cleansing Wildfire and Dire Strain Rampage to punish these greedy One Island, Timur, or Jeskai, Hinata decks, or even Esper with like one Plains, to punish basically these three color decks. Cleansing Wildfire is very, very strong in terms of the opponent has to search for basic and cannot search for anything else when you destroy land. Dire Strain Rampage is a little weaker. The opponent can search for a dual land, a tri land, any land basically with a basic land type. So that means Raphine's Tower, Sparrow's Headquarters, etc. can be searched up with Dire Strain Rampage from the opponent's side. But the huge upside about Dire Strain Rampage is that if that is the case and you're playing against Esper or what have you, and they have that tri land they can just fetch out, you can just target yourself. You can target your own land and then get two lands into play on your side, which basically is a ramp spell. And then you can also choose to, I don't know, in the late game, blow up a Wedding Announcement, a Reckoner Bankbuster, what have you. There's flexibility because not only you can destroy land, you can destroy an artifact enchantment. And yeah, we got Fable of the Mirrorbreaker. I mean, I'm basically playing some of the best cards in the format here, and then I'm mixing some of the more fun land destruction spells. Fun, exclamation marks. Field of Ruin, I shouldn't forget. But yeah, Field of Ruin, of course, in there as well. Yeah, Fable of the Mirrorbreaker, very, very strong card. Of course, we all know it. And especially with Titan of Industry, you have a plan. You have a plan to just outmuscle the opponent. Then another four, Burn Down the House. That's a card that's going to stick with us through rotation. Same with Fable and Shigeki and Dire Strain Rampage and Titan, actually. But Cleansing Wildfire is an important one that's going to miss. In any case, Burn Down the House, flexible, can create devils when you're on the offensive. And when you're behind, deal 5 damage to each creature and each planeswalker. Very good against Boros aggro, very good against the various Jund and Esper midrange decks. So I think this is exactly the type of card I want to have. I'm blowing up the opponent's lands. That means I'm taking time off. They can deploy more things, but then I can catch back up with that Burn Down the House. I tried this deck a little bit. I tried some versions, and I had, I don't know the name of the card. It's a saga with some trolls. Waking the Trolls, exactly. I played that as a 4-off instead of Titan. And I must say, when you are like behind, or even when you're sort of, I don't know, at parity, like when you're at parity it's fine, but when you're behind playing, casting, using 6 mana, destroying one land of the opponent, and then on the second chapter, just getting one land back, it just didn't feel good enough. Like, I wish this would be nice enough, but it just, no. This is just not strong enough. It's too slow, unfortunately. But we do have a little bit of troll shenanigans going on. We have one Nutvolt Slumber Mound, which we can sacrifice for 6 mana, destroy a land, and create a 4/4 green troll warrior creature token with trample, which is very nice when you have Ezika's Chariot after they Meetup massacred your cats away, getting a 4/4 crew and making another 4/4 with the copy. So, yeah, I exchanged the Waking the Trolls for Titan of Industry. Titan of Industry is just, you know, this late-game house stabilizing threat. Reach is very nice against the various flying 4/4s that are running around. Or flying around, better. Yeah, so Titan of Industry is the card we are playing. And yeah, the mana base is pretty straightforward. We have a decent amount of basics. So Field of Ruin and Dire Strain Rampage. Don't run out of those when we use them. All right, I think that's enough about the main deck. Let's take a look at the sideboard. We have Flame Blast Bolt number 4 against aggro. We have some Tangle Traps against the Flyers. Bribage Tracker is a nice, versatile card. Could see it in the main deck too, but didn't quite know how to make space for it. Just, you know, you can bring it in against aggro. You can bring it in against control. And then we have a Braids, Funnering Rebukes, more removal, Reckoner Bankbuster for the grind value, and some Workshop War Chiefs to stabilize in the mid-game against aggressive decks, against Junt, against Boros Aggro. It's pretty nice. It's also quite good at Fable of the Mirrorbreaker. Overall, I try to make sure to have enough cards, like Bribage Track and Workshop Warchief and Reckoner Bankbuster for them. They're very flexible, and you can bring them in against a lot of decks. For example, if I get paired against a deck that literally have like 10 basics in the deck, because, I don't know, Orzhov or whatever, then it's nice to be able to board out the land destruction spells because they just are really bad, and bring in some of these fair mid-range cards, and then you're just going to become a fair mid-range deck, which is very fine as well. Okay, I think that's been enough talking. Let's get into the games. Play, and what do we have? Standard, ranked, best of 3, please. Red Green Ponza. All right, guys. One, perhaps my last hooray in the standard format here on Channel Fireball. We'll see about that, I suppose. I will check the recording. It looks like it is working. Beautiful. All right, let's see if we can pair against someone in this standard queue. Hope you don't miss my face too much, guys. Entering match, let's go. I must say the vacation has been really nice, but it's also nice to play some Magic again. We've been here for 4 days now in the Austrian Alps, in the Austrian mountains. We've been hiking a lot, walking a ton. My legs are hurting like crazy. All right, enough about that. On the draw, I have a Flame Blast Bolt, and I have an Ezika's Chariot. I mean, 5 lands is a lot, but I have some utility lands. I think I'm gonna keep this. Let's see if this Nordvolt Slumber Mound can do something. Alright, we get paired against basic planes. That's maybe not the best sign. Orzhov it is. Looks like Orzhov. Alright. Means my land destruction probably won't be as good as I want it to be. That's okay. They have the Spiritual Companion. Probably they also have Restoration of Elganjo. Maybe they have Rite of Oblivion. That's some symbology. Haven't seen that card in a long time. I would think that there are better 2-drops than that one. Okay, so looks like my opponent is missing lands. Alright, I'll take the one, but kill off the Professor here. Seiju. Okay. Seiju can also be land destruction against Jessica Hinata. When they are out of basics and they don't have a Rafine's Tower to get. Is Seiju basically Dire Strain Rampage on a land? Pretty much, right? Pretty much. Huh. I mean, Dire Strain Rampage is better because you can blow up your own stuff, your own lands, and then get lands. But hey, not bad. Seiju is not bad. You can see that on its price on Channel Firewall. Alright, let's play this Chariot. Okay, opponent unsurprisingly had another basic to get, but we blew up a Hive of the Eye Tyrant, so that was good value. No matter what. Okay, Wandering Emperor, Mitok Massacre, Vanishing Verse. Alright. Fine by me. It is certainly a matchup where I'm going to bring in the Bankbuster and the Tracker and so on and so on. Fortell, God, is that a Starnheim Unleashed? That'd be really scary. I can make some 1/1s and attack. I think that's a little bit overly aggressive, especially because if I do so and they just have a Mitok, I'm kind of, you know, losing a lot. So I think I'm just going to do nothing, pass the turn, and then likely Sokinzan in the end step, I guess. Make some 1/1s. I don't know. It's pretty anemic. But perhaps I'm going to do so. I got this Shigeki to draw some more stuff. Wedding announcement. I might just Poseidon that, honestly. Yeah, I'm probably just doing that. I'm going to make 1/1/1. Yeah, I'm just going to Poseidon that. I mean, I guess I could have tightened it 2 turns down the line. They would get 2 1/1s out of the deal. A little bit annoying. Burn down. Burn down the house. This could also be a Doomsky, I suppose. I guess I can just fire off this burn down. I mean, they will just sweep the board, though. Then I play a Titan. I guess that's all fine. Yeah, if they sweep, it's fine. I mean, Mitok Massacre would be annoying because they gain so much life back. But I can deal with that. I mean, I honestly hope this is just a Doomsky, yes. I mean, a Starnheim Unleashed wouldn't be the worst. They play a land, make 3 angels. It's a Doomsky. Now they go to 10. Then I play a Titan. Make a shield counter on the Titan. And make a 4/4. 11 power. That's a good one. That's a good one. Evil. I will play Titan. I could gain life, but no. I actually put the shit count on this. I guess I'll do that. Okay. Restoration. And get back a 1/1. To draw a card. Yeah, I mean, here the land destruction is really not that great. So Shigeki can return some things. Not legendary things, right? Non-legendary cards. So it can return Poseidon. It looks like they have Wandering Emperor, doesn't it? Makes me sad. What do I do against the Emperor? Just attack with the Rhino? This game is gonna go for a while, I feel like. They don't attack at all, they're just gonna play the Emperor. I think that's best, actually. I think I won't attack at all. Yeah.
I'll just pass it down. If they go for the Emperor, make it 2-2. No, they won't do anything. Interesting. Yeah, I mean, that's also a play, I guess, but at least they burn 5 mana in a way. They discarded Companion to get it back. Sure. Another Restoration. Oh, they're out of planes. 5 planes in total. Alright, noted. Duly noted. Okay, they keep up the Emperor again. I can blow up a land with the Nord Vault. Or I can make some devils, get back Flame Blast Bolt, get back a Field of Ruin. I'd blow up a land. Yeah, I think I'll just get the burn down. It's kind of nice with the Rhino. Because I have a shield counter on the Rhino, so I can... They get these restoration to become 3/4s. I can then blow up everything and the Rhino survives. Second Field of Ruin. I am going to play this slow, I think. I will just play a Fable and a Field of Ruin. Yeah. And then I'll pass the turn. This costs 6 to activate. Yeah. It's quite expensive. I put it in my deck. Shouldn't complain about it, but here we are. I mean, it's the little fun of troll land. Gotta troll our opponent sometimes. All right. I mean, we're really 5 mana each turn pinned down. I think I'm just gonna blow up this Shattered Sanctum. Why not? I guess I should do so after the trigger resolves, technically. Anyways. We're not here for the high professional pro level play, are we? We're just here for some fun red-green Ponzer brew action from your casual commentator, Arne Huschenbeth. All right. What do you want to get back? So they have a second Swamp. Noted. They have a Bankbuster. Okay. Good card. That makes... my position a little precarious, maybe? Soul Shatter. I will lose my creature. Do you want to play an angel? You do. So now I can burn down. And the Rhino survives. But I still have... 2 more angels coming, a Wandering Emperor in hand, very likely. And a Bankbuster and a Restoration. So, if I find another Titan, that'd be good. Oh, that's a good start. That is a good start. Blow up Bankbuster and Restoration. Kind of want to discard it as well because it's value out of the graveyard. But I kind of need it to kill these two because I'm going to burn down this turn. I'm just going to do this. Okay. Not a fable. So 5, 9, 10 mana with an attack. So 10 mana with an attack. Okay. This gives me an tap land. Okay, I'll just 5-9 mana. So I'll just cast these two, I guess. I'll just cast Fable and this. No. You could also wait another turn. Just let him have the angels. Let him get this restoration. Wait another turn. Just blow up this Bankbuster. It will take 8 in the air though, which is kind of painful. I'll just start by this, by doing this. I can attack the 2/2 to make a treasure if I really want the 8th mana this turn. Now, how many swamps do you have? Probably one more. No? Just 2. Okay, we got him out of basics. Let's go. This is actual land destruction now. I'm just worried about all this stuff. It's just so much value. I mean, I could 5. It's tough. I don't know, this is tough, this is really difficult. I really need another Titan. Oh, I guess a Shigeki would help. Just to get a Titan. No attacks, so I go to 5. Oh, that's good. That's freaking great. That's freaking great. That's annoying. Area's call. All of those are indestructible now. Oh no, I did a mistake. Oh my god, I forgot. Stupid interaction. I was like, this is a free block. But no, it actually isn't, because I'm losing my shield counter now. What am I doing, guys? What am I doing? That was a punt. Damn it. That hurts. So now I'm gonna lose everything and they're gonna be left with this. Alright. Good enough for me to concede. Yeah, I can kill one, but I'm pretty dead. Okay, yeah. Yeah, this is not the type of deck I want to get paired against, of course, but my play wasn't optimal either. I might want to keep some of these rampages. Flame Blast Bolt doesn't look so hot. Tracker looks good. Bankbuster looks decent. Yeah, this is really not the matchup I want to get paired against, like a grindy black-white deck that can deal with all my threats with their various answers. And that has Bankbusters and lots of 2-for-1s. No, this is not the matchup I want to get paired against. Also not the matchup where this card is very good. Like a 5-3. It just gets Vanishing Burst. Pretty bad here. And think about Rebuke. I can just play more Rampage. Yeah, I don't know. I think I guess I gotta win. Yeah, I have to play the Rebukes, I feel like, because of the Restoration as well. It's a 3-4 after all. And then I'll probably just play this Rampage to blow up all their various enchantments. And Bankbusters, and then call it a day. Burndawn looks pretty decent against them. The raids are fine. Titan seems fine. Yeah, I just have to... I mean, first of all, don't get paired against stupid Orzhov. I haven't played against such an Orzhov deck in a long time. But in any case, after not getting paired against a deck like that, yeah, your strategy probably has to be to... Shigeki plus Titan, multiple Titans, and then just somehow go over the top. Multiple Chariots, of course. Yeah, just draw Titan, Chariot, Shigeki, stuff like that. It's a good strategy here, I think. It's definitely not unlosable. Perhaps I was too greedy in the last game, should have burned down the turn earlier. But I don't, I don't think I would have beaten those 4-4 angels anyhow. Even if I burn down sooner. I'll just ramp myself here. Kaboom. Forest and a montagna. If it may click. May I? Thank you. Oh no. Good one. I could kill it. Or I could wait. And kill both of those. Yeah, I think I will happily wait a turn and then kill both with the Shadow Skull. Seems like good value. Keeping up the Vanishing Wars, huh? Both attack. Should have just forced the issue here with the chariot. So.
Vanishing Wars!
Inferno Grasp. Yeah. Yeah, this is a slight mistake by the opponent. If I have Snakeskin Veil, respond it there and then. Punish my opponent for not doing it in response to the crew. Well, a little victory of mine here. That's the power of Chariot. They traded their spell for my Chariot. I'm left with 4 power on 2 bodies. Quite good. Quite good. Would have fought Ezika's Chariot. I gotta say, I'm not gonna miss that one if it rotates. I'm not gonna miss that one. I've been on the receiving end of Ezika's Chariot more than I've been on the... I mean, I've played Monogreen aggro and won Pro Tour. But that wasn't, yeah, I mean, that was a fine, I think I went 4-3 there. It was a fine deck, but should have just played the Team Is It Epiphany deck. I wanted to level the metagame, didn't work out. Anyways, so, yeah, what are we doing here? They just passed. Let's attack. Shigeki. Already on chump block mode. I could ramp myself one more time. I could Shigeki back a forest and a Shadow Skull smashing. I think I'm just gonna use this one to ramp myself. What the heck? The auto tap lets this one. Oh, that's just golden. I guess I could have been more careful. Okay, we have 2 more basics left in our deck. That's not a lot. So my own Field of Ruin and my own Dire Strain Rampages on myself will be worse. Which, I mean, yeah. 2 basics left is alright. We know the opponent has 5 planes, 2 swamps. Do nothing. Just a Wandering Emperor here. That's the case. I'm just going to make a 7-7 Titan. Yep. Run away. They're going to make a 2-2 here. They kill one. Okay.
This is what you get for hurting my people.
They have another. They have like a Vanishing Verse here.
Thank you.
No, they don't. Sing. Ah, come on. How do I beat that? 4 cards left. Also exiled in my graveyard. Yikes. Yikes.
We've got the edge in this fight.
Do I just play one Shigigi here? I think so. Well, unfortunate, but... I mean, I have another one. Yeah, I mean, this is really not the type of matchup I want to get paired against. Really the opposite of that. Okay. Another Shigeki. Not funny. So, okay, I guess I'll just start by activating the Shigeki. Nice. Oh, look at that. Okay. I would take 8 damage, go to 6. I could just return one rebuke, kill everything, but nah. I'll return rebuke and burn down, or bankbuster and burn down end of turn. Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. I go to 6, and yeah. See where that leads us. Oh, all right. Well, I can respond to that. Yeah, what are you gonna do? Dire Strain Rampage? The burn down. Well, I'm just gonna respond to that. If you don't mind. Take a this and take a this. I trust in autopay. I only have 6 mana, so it doesn't matter. Alright. Maybe this is a thing I have to turn off, actually. Auto tap. Now, this is definitely turn off. Rests. I mean, this, no. Okay. Down to 2 cards. I'm down to 6. Let's pop the board. Might have a Wandering Emperor end of turn. That would result in 3 more damage to me. That would be somewhat okay with me. Doesn't look like they have anything. Alright. The Geki gonna get us there. Ooh, okay. Good one. I can blow it up with a Dire Strain Rampage. More lands, let's go. Chariot. Alright. Which actually... how am I gonna do this? So I have 5, 10, 11 mana here. I can use 5, 9, 11? Okay. I'll play the Chariot, right? Yeah. And then I can activate the Bank Buster as well. Perfect. My opponent has a Vanishing Verse here. I can tell. Because all of a sudden they have priority again, right? Because before that they didn't really have priority. I mean, I would guess so, but maybe I'm overthinking here. Ah, that's really freaking good. Ah, Farewell is such a beast against me. Like, damn, that's the single best card you could have. My deck, because the graveyard exiling is so important too. Yikes. Okay, alright. Evil, okay. We'll kill that, I guess. And then I will play a Fable. Sure. Could play a Shigeki. I'm a little bit worried that my opponent has a sweeper. I don't want to lose two creatures to a sweeper. Pass the turn. I will discard these two, I guess. Okay. I will attack for two, then end of turn, blow up one of their lands with my Not Vault Slumber Mound. It's troll time. A Ganjo, sure. And then I can return the Not Vault Slumber Mount with my Shigeki. You see where I'm going? Looks like we're successfully grinding out this Ozov player. I could sacrifice my Leia here if I want to. Nah, I think I'm good. But I think I'm gonna use one Shigeki. Yeah. And return the Shadow Skull. The Not Vault. Okay. There's a tracker. Sweet. How about 6? Attack for 6. And play a tracker post combat and play a tapped Not Vault Slumber Mount. I apologize to all the Not Vault Slumber Mount aficionados from Kaltheim, if I'm mispronouncing that oh so beautiful name. Okay, that is going to lead to me casting a Shadow Skull Smashing. 6 damage to each of you guys. This is Zendikar Rising Mythic All-Stars Shadow Skull Smashing against Emeria's Call here. So I can copy. Yeah, I think I'll just copy instead of playing like my tracker. I guess we can also sack a clue. Hope to make a land drop. Fine with that as well. All right, sweet. Going to game 3. Any moment. A Kanuma. What do we got? Welcoming Vampire is the only option. That is game. Devils. Is it? I guess not. I mean, it's the second one is game. Second one is game. Cool. Otherwise, it would have just been 7 damage. But yeah. Head Explosion. Okay. Didn't see any Wandering Emperor. I saw Welcoming Vampire multiple times. No Restoration this game. Oh, we did draw one Emperor, I guess. I forgot about that. It was a long game. Lots of removal and farewell. Jesus Christ. Maybe I cut a Shigeki against these farewells. I mean, Shigeki is also a fine creature to just play. And even if they farewell, after the farewell, you can always just play your Shigeki. And then they have to kill it, otherwise you fill up your graveyard again. Find stuff to return. It's a self... Shigeki is a Blanky, of course, but it is an engine in itself, which is pretty cool. Ramp a couple times, and then later on return everything. Okay, I mean, I can live with this. I can ramp myself to a turn 4 burn down the house and have a bank bust on turn 2. Good enough for me. And they used up an Emeria's Call, so that means they are light on lands, I would say. Lay off the Hydra. Well, the welcoming vampire. Should I just kill it? Or should I set up my burn down? I think I should just set up my burn down. Because the welcoming vampire incentivizes my opponent to commit more to the board. The worst card I could see, I guess, is betting announcement. Because this is sort of fine, I guess. Like, yeah, they get to draw two cards, but at least they use their entire turn for this stuff. I go to 16. Bankbuster. Okay. I could also... Interesting. I could rampage the Bankbuster and just kill this welcoming vampire. Maybe that's a good idea. And then they're left with 1/1s, but I have this burn down for later. My energy was low because my laptop wasn't actually connected. Cable wasn't entirely inside. Happens. Oh, we're good. Alright. There's a Doomscar, I hope. And if not, it's fine as well. I will draw some cards. Looks like a Wandering Emperor here. Chariot. Huh. Yeah, why not? Honestly, why not? Like, even if I'm gonna burn down next turn, I'm gonna be left with that vehicle on the board, which is probably gonna be good later on. When I draw... Okay, that's fine too. Now I don't even have to burn down, right? Like, my 2/2s are dominating the board state now. So my opponent has to deploy more things. I mean, I didn't even have to burn down in any case, like against 2/1s. But yeah, this gives me a lot more time. I have this bank buster going. I'm pretty happy about the situation right now. And there's a Shigeki. Just draw more cards, I guess. Another rampage, oh my god. Back with a kitty. Nah, I think I'm just gonna be staying back here. Maybe one can attack, I guess. Sure. I can ramp myself with a rampage. It just block. What is this? Double block, okay. Yeah, I guess I'll just ramp myself with a rampage here. out of the graveyard. I Gendra. Okay, they're down to two cards and likely a Doomscar. By the way, the sound is a little bit off. That's Arena lately. They have a little bit bugged sound, unfortunately. It's not my fault. Five, eight mana here. I don't have anything good in the graveyard. Guess I can just make devils, but then they're gonna Doomscar. I'm gonna do something maybe weird, but I kind of like it. I'm going to return two lands and a braid. Just make land drops. You know, no rush. No rush, no rush on anything. Fill up my hand. They are just sitting on Vanishing Verse, maybe a Farewell, maybe a Fateful Absence and a Doomscar. If I'm deploying like a Burndown, it won't do much. That's the perfect card to draw, honestly. Cool. Yeah. I'd be a little bit worried about time, I guess, but otherwise I'm good. Sure, so maybe I'll just push out the Burndown here, force the issue. Well, yeah, why not? Why not? I have so much mana, I have so much removal. I guess Farewell would be rough, I guess. Farewell would be kind of rough here. Yeah, I kind of had this Doomscar. I was like, yeah, I'm fine with training with Doomscar, but if they have a Farewell, it wouldn't be great. But this doesn't look like the way they blocked it does not look like a Farewell. If they have Farewell, they should chump block the cat too. Yeah. Not lose life. Okay, let's hope they don't have Farewell, I guess. But even if they do, you still get to draw two cards. And I'm left with six cards in hand. A Shigeki, some removal. I just got to draw one Titan, a Chariot. Yeah, okay, they don't have Farewell. That makes things easy. Now I'm going to sack, use this. Get a treasure, use the other one. There's a Titan, sweet. Farewell is a scary one, though. That card just knocks my entire plan out. Okay. It's funny, right? Like, I'm red-green Ponza, technically, but apparently not. Apparently, I'm just grinding people out the good old red-green mid-range way. All right. I put a shield counter and I make a Rhino. Put a shield counter on the Titan. Crew this. Attack for 8. So now they can Doomscar, but then they still have to kill the Titan. Somehow, some way. That's fine. $7.40 on the clock, all good. Let's draw a card, make a land drop. No land drop. Could play Shatter Skull Smashing. Nah. Okay. Yes. So this Lair is going to hit for 9. 5, 8, 9. 9 damage. I'm just gonna do this back for 7. Ass. End of turn, I get another 4/4. I have this lair next turn to kill them. Ah, this looks pretty good. I have a shadow skull to get rid of blockers. If they have like Wandering Emperor, I still have 9 power and they're at 7. If I activate the lair, they kill that, and then I still have 5/9 power, so. All bueno. Yeah, don't mess with the red green grindy player here. Gosh, I really hope our next opponent will be Jessica Hinata. I want to destroy some lands for good. I'm gonna punish those greedy free color decks. Ah, oh, is my opponent salty? Yeah, salty loser. Are we gonna rope me out? Yeah, is it that type of player? Ah, yeah. Emotions. I mean, okay, all right. Never mind. Not roping. Just had to take some time to cast that farewell. Okay. But I do have this layer of the Hydra, which is going to swing in there. Poor lethal. So you need something else. Okay. I mean, that's enough. Because if I abrade that, I have 6, 7, 8 power. 6, 7, 8. Yep. Not enough. Okay. Then I guess play double tracker. And attack for 4. Pass. Attack for 4, I guess. They have another farewell. They're gonna lose. I'm gonna jump. And if they have farewell, now I have a 10-10. Right? Yeah. 11-11 even. 6-9. 10-10. Okay, that's not enough. That's not enough. 6 and 6. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Leave the layer up. Make the layer a 2-2. Swing for 10. Wow, what a game. Two like off matter tier 3.5 decks clutching it out in the percentages. I mean, I enjoyed that very much. I hope you did enjoy that as well. All right, sweet. that was a good match. And apologies if I was assuming my opponent was going to rope me out there. We're on the draw yet again. And my hand is interesting. Shigeki and 2 lands can work out. I think I'm gonna keep. I do have an early removal if I draw into red. And I have double Shigeki, I have a Cleansing Wildfire, I have a Chariot. I think this hand's okay. I could see mulliganing it, but if Shigeki survives, I'm gonna be okay. And I have I want to draw, so I have a lot of draw steps to just naturally draw into mana. I'm playing 27 lands, so... Duress and a cave. Oh my god, are we playing against black-white nonsense yet again? That would be annoying. Looks like it, though. I guess at the end of standard, people are just bringing their fun decks. I like my Orzhov deck. I'm just gonna play that. I hate Jeskai, Hinata, and Timur, and Grixis. I wanna play my Orzhov deck. I mean, no fault to anybody. Magic's a game of... You can play it in various ways. And I've, there has been an Orzhov deck that was somewhat successful in Standard a couple weeks ago at the Standard Challenge. But it fell off quickly. It was like a discard shell with multiple discard spells and Acquisition Expert. And it had Extraction Specialist to get the Acquisitions Expert and Luminarch Aspirant back from the graveyard. But I don't think it was a particularly good deck. Oh my god, so many cards drawn, no land. Am I the most unlucky player in the world? I think so. I'm just gonna pass the turn here, I guess. No reason to do any... maybe I should do it now. Because... Whew, almost a miss. Jesus. Maybe I should do it now because then they can't kill it in response. Me activating it? Wait a minute. That's not how it works. It just returns to your hand immediately. So there's no way the opponent can kill it when you activate it. Good to know, good to know. So here I can Dire Strain Rampage myself. Or you can just play Fable. I think it's a Fable for me. I mean, Revealing Eye and Duress. I guess I see what my opponent's going for here. Just a heavy discard in different ways. Revealing Eye is pretty annoying for like a blue red deck. Vaulted Surge and a treasure, I guess, is the solution. Strike fast and strike hard. Yeah, I mean, I missed a little bit too many land drops here. That's also quite the card against Hinata, I guess. Yeah, my opponent has an Orzhov build that tries to dig at Hinata, and accidentally, so pretty good against me, I suppose. Just these two, I guess. I don't even know what I'm looking for. It's pretty desperate at this point. Nine life. So I want to get this Titan down, I suppose. Put two counters on each permanent. They have a cave over there. Yeah. I guess I gotta try to make them block the owl, then abrade the owl and play a Fable post combat. I hope that's enough. And I guess, yeah. Just miss on the top seven. How about that? Total miss. That'd be a start. The suspense. Yeah, I wouldn't consider that a total miss. Alright, thank you very much. Burn on the House looks pretty good against my opponent, though. They have Luminarch and Silver Cool Silencer. My Dire Strain Rampage looks less good here. I didn't see any restorations. I think they still have... the vetting announcement, because they all have vetting announcement. It's engraved in Orzhov's DNA. So yeah, they seem a lot more aggressive though. Maybe an abrade. Maybe it's too much removal. I'm gonna play Rampage. Piece of vetting announcement. What, two? Still have four burned out in the house. Like, I don't need that much spot removal. Especially when I'm on the play, I think. Although they do have duress and discard, so they can just mess with my burn down if I try setting that up. Ooh. Nah, I can't keep this one. On the draw, I probably keep, but not on the play. Interesting. Jigeki and Bankbuster are kind of similar. Two mana to find me something. Jigeki finds me lands, which I really need. But Jigeki also dies to Vanishing Verse. Well, Bankbuster likely does not. Nah, whatever. I'll just put back the Rebuke. I was thinking between these two, but I'll just put back the Rebuke. And that makes me want to play the Bankbuster, honestly. Because then I can curve into Tracker and attack for four. Cool. Who's the beatdown now? Interesting. Certainly Shigeki. But what else? Is it Chariot? Or is it just another Tracker? Tracker's really freaking good here. Like, imagine that I'm gonna hit my opponent down to 8. It's just so good. Like, I don't want to take a risk and keep the Chariot and then just draw a bunch of high cost cards and not be able to play a spell. While I have this beautiful turn here, putting my opponent has so much pressure, still being left with all this mana at this card advantage, even if my creatures get dealt with somehow. Right. That's not really a solution to their problems. Okay. So I'll start with a clue, because I might draw Shigeki. So now I'm a little bit worried about a Mitook Massacre. So I don't think I want to play the Shigeki. I'll just... I guess I could have drawn into a Flame Blast Bolt. I didn't even think about that. That was a little sloppy of mine. No. Okay, no Mitook. This costs 6 to activate. So one more mana. Okay. trackers are a serious headache for my opponent. My sideboard plan is working out fantastically. Okay. Sure. I destroy the planes because they seem to be bottlenecked on white. The hive, I don't really care about right now. There. Chariot. Oh, wow. I could have just gone for the kill there. Well, yeah. No apologies, honestly. Like, I don't hear... Yeah. I was, like, so into just... I think, like, my play is somewhat reasonable. Actually, I think, but... not sure. Seen enough. Yeah, I think my play is reasonable, but like to not go for it in that moment. There's no. Yeah, I mean, you can go for it, but Hagra Mauling could have been a card, I guess. I don't know. Whatever. Any changes? Oh, blank, huh? Good against Shigeki. Pretty good against Shigeki. On the draw, I could put another removal in my deck, maybe over a Shigeki. Raid or Bolt? I'll take the Bolt. Yeah, it seemed like a deck that could have Tenacious Underdog as well. They're playing Silencer and Luminarch. Underdog really does make sense in a deck, doesn't it? You want to be... discarding the opponent's interaction, removal, what have you, and then beat down with Underdogs and Luminarch Aspirants. Underdog is quite good against my deck as well, if I'm on the back foot. Yeah, this hand is reasonable. You could also certainly make the case that Reckon a Bankbuster is a main deck card, maybe instead of some of the Shigeki. That's a pretty good start. Oh my god, the big curtains would be very annoying. Can't really get rid of that. Guess I can double block it with a Titan. Luminarch Aspirant is a card I really don't want to see on the opponent's side. This curtains card also seems very annoying. Could I find a burn down the house? That'd be sweet. Back for 6, go to 14. Oh, okay. That's a good start. Okay. Yeah, I mean, if I find a burn down, I'm in a really nice position. Just gotta find it. I have 4 in my deck. If I don't, these things are gonna be annoying. Mm-hmm. In return, rebuke. Yes! Yes! I even played a little hasty because I did it a little too fast. They could have had the rest in the second main phase. That was very sloppy. But I mean, if you're playing online, you just play fast sometimes. It's how it is. Interesting. Okay. So they hit me down to a 4, play a Legion Angel. I play Titan, gain 5, make a 4-4. Could also just Shigeki my opponent. Return a burn down. If I play Chariot, attack 4, they go to 16. Then I play Titan, I attack 4. 12? Is that correct? 4, 8, 12. I mean, a 2-2 will get blocked by a Legion Angel. But we'll attack for 10. Put them down to 6. And I have a Titan, a Rhino. I'm on 9 life. If they block the Bankbuster here, am I happy? I think I'm happy. Alright, let's go. I could also go with the Shigeki line. I didn't really think it entirely through. But I think this seems pretty good too. I don't know how this gets wrong, how this goes wrong really. I go to 4, I go up to 9. If they have a discard spell for my Titan, I can then Shigeki Thundering Rebuke necessary. They're really thinking about it. My red-green deck, it's just grinding out these these decks. Yeah, it's certainly legit to block there. But I think I'm pretty happy with that. The board is empty now. I have a really strong hand. Yeah, this is great for me. I'm just gonna gain 5, make a 4-4. Easy. The power, that's just the power of these mid-rangey good cards that the deck has access to. I'm also gonna attack with the cats. Maybe a little bit too aggressive, but I think it's fine. Yeah, they're just blocking a chariot anyways. So the cat attack is great if they do that. So now they need like a Doomskull or Farewell. Next turn, I'm just going to return like chariot, burn down, and a Titan with my Shigeki. Yeah, good luck. Good luck, opponent. Good luck winning this one. I can make them chump block here. Oh, I guess not. Block a cat, take 10. No, I can make them chump block my lair if I want to. They go to 4, 12, go to 4. Sure, why not, I guess. Right, this is how it works. If they block a kitten, they die. They have to chump block the 6-6 and then they still take 10, 12. Yeah, how do they get out of this? If they have a sweeper, I kill them with lair. They block the kitten. Well, that makes it simple. We are not in the percentages anymore. Huh, okay. So my red-green deck that is supposed to beat the greedy decks that only have one basic is beating Orzhov back to back. Okay. I guess it's good to know. But it's not why I'm doing this. So let's hope we play against the meta deck now that we are in the numbers. Check if the recording is working. Looks good. Okay, perfect. Everybody loves to hear great comeback story. Never give up. Fair, fair. Jalapeno business. Oh my god, we're playing against 59%. Yikes. I have a feeling that this opponent won't have the most best deck ever. This hand is a little too shaky. I don't even have a cheap spell. Oh my god. I guess I'm going to keep on the basis of Flame Best Bolt. I really don't want to go to 5. Do not go. Lunark Veteran. Uh-huh. Black White Life Gain. I assume the Veteran is kinda good for my opponent. And Flame Blast Bolt exiling it is extra nice there. Wow. Alright. That was... You got me there, I guess. Strong place. How is it possible that we're getting paired against Black White 3 times in a row? How is that a thing? Shigeki, shigeki, shigeki. What am I supposed to do here? I think I'm just gonna blow up cave, play a shigeki. Snakey, snakey. All right, the angel is dangerous, huh? Touché. Yeah, playing the Shigeki looks pretty bad now. I regret my decision. The Potation Circle. Oh my god. Our over there. Mighty Zendikar Rising, Marauding Blight Priest. Oh, you don't even want to attack. Sounds good. Don't mind if I do. Cool. Deja vu. I'll discard Flameless Bolt and land yet again. It's just, I was planning to play a red-green land destruction deck. As it turns out, I'm just playing a red burn control mid-range deck. Okay, again, Cleansing Wildfire looks pretty terrible. Dice Drain Rampage doesn't look very good. I'll play all the removal I have, I suppose. And Trekkerino for good measures. Tangle Trap, good against a Flyer. I guess the Rampage is good against the Circle. Alright, fine. I also have Titan to blow up Circle. I mean, Rampage is also a ramp spell on myself. So, yeah, it's flexible. I can do better. I want some cheap removal. Or burn down the house. Fable the Mirror Breaker. Stuff like that. Okay. In the Titan. Yeah, 4 Shigeki might be overkill. I can see that. Maybe you just want like 2 Shigeki or 3 Shigeki. And then play a Bankbuster instead of the other Shigekis. Ah, this is just painful. This is really good. Well, by my math, this cleric will be a 5/5. Ooh, Jesus Christ. That is really strong. Damn. They have a card draw engine now. Yikes. Oh, that's convenient. One turn earlier, I wouldn't have mind, but I'll take it. Mm-hmm. Yep. Do a thing. So I take 5, go to 7. Nah, the cleric doesn't even attack. I don't know why, but it does not attack. I have no idea why, but sure. Okay, I go to 8, and then down to 7. And then, burn down. Against 3 cards in hand. Okay. The Righteous Valkyrie is a huge problem because it's a 4/6 because they have 27. So let's hope they don't draw that one. That's a big issue too. Yeah, I mean, depends. That's actually not that bad. Just Shadow Skull does too. This means I won't have Titan guaranteed. I'm at 7.
I'll just blow up my own land.
And then I play a Titan. Lotus up. Pick 2, go to 5. Ah, damn. Ay, ay, ay. Menace. Ah, the Dire Strain Rampage was so much worse than a land. Just like a 3-mana land. Pretty bad here. But okay. And found the line of attacking for 2. Well played. Great. Okay. If I make a 4/4 and destroy the vetting, I will have enough blockers, but I'm on a pretty low life total. I think I will just gain the 5. Yeah, I could also leave them with the... I could also make a 4/4 and gain 5, actually. Leave them with the wedding. I have the Rampage anyways. This sounds best, actually, yeah. Look at that synergy. If they exile my Rampage, that wouldn't be nice. No, they gain life. Sounds good. Okay. Yeah. Oh my god, I mean, if you put 4 Dawnbringer Clerics into your deck, you probably shouldn't be surprised to be at 59%. So, okay. Okay. Early 6 life. Lord. Chariot. Okay. All right, all right, all right. And a fable. No blocks. I mean, I could triple block in a 1-1. That wouldn't be so bad, but okay. On the chariot. My red-green mid-range deck, oh my god. Can't believe it. Unbelievable. Oh, okay, Been a long video already, but I'm gonna play one more match. One more match for you guys. To hope to finally face a deck where we can really ponza the opponent. I'll just get water real quick while we're waiting. I'm still in the percentages. Yikes. 69%. Okay. No, thank you. So many mulligans. Okay, perfect. Come on, Hinata. Another black deck. Seriously? Blue black. Ledger Shredder. All right. How many bases do you got? What am I playing against? Esper? Swamp. Okay. Another island? Jeez, everybody has infinite basics. Kaito! Yikes. All right.
Thanks. I'll be taking that now.
Oof. That's a big one. Okay. Just gotta find burn on the house. Everybody has infinite basics. It's so sad. Can't put stops. Oh, they let that happen. That's cool. I've been watching your moves. All right, so now we have three more draws into a burn down. They get to Ledger Shredder. I can't do anything about that. That's fine. Yeah, okay. We're just... I mean, people are just playing their fun decks. I get it. Have your opponent draw a card? No. You can hit me for damage. Although you do have a lot of cards already. Maybe I could have just given them another one. Maybe.
There's no secret I can't uncover.
Another. Okay. Okay. I mean, if I find a burn down, I'm very much in the game. dang it. I'm at 10. I mean, the funny thing is that these guys I can just shut off. At least for a turn. Chump block. Okay.
Fine. I'll find another way.
Don't want to play Shigeki here. No, I don't think so. Also triggers this Ledger Shredder, which is a problem. Ledger Shredder gets 4 toughness. 6 toughness. Not 4, 6. Gonna be an issue. Alright. You may draw a card. You may draw a card again. Nice one. So they gain life, I guess. Okay, fine. I can pay for that. Can't pay for the second one. Yeah, perhaps not my best matchup ever. Blue black Ledger Shredder counter spells. Kaito on the play. Tangle Trap consideration, I suppose. Blue black. I like going mid range route here. Titan is good though. Wanna kill everything. Draw some cards. Maybe cut a burn down. Play Banky Boy. All right, let's go. Let's go. Let's get this. Spell Pierce. Spell Pierce is really good against Burn Down. All right, I can work with this. Once mulliganing. Hmm. Okay. Drawing land is very lucky. Like that. They can just counter it to get the hermit in the graveyard. Probably a good idea to do so. Yes, and they do so. I think I'll just reveal the rebuke. Two cards left in hand. I'll just pass. Could have activated main phase, I guess. Find a Fable or something. Or a Chariot. I'm not sure if I would have played a Chariot. I would have played a Chariot, though. Sorry, a Fable. I would have played a Fable. I wouldn't have played a Chariot, I think, because I wouldn't have had the mana to pay for spell pierce if I played Chariot. And even playing a Fable is a little counterproductive when you have a burn on the house that you want to set up. Okay, now I'm just going to play Titan and put a shield counter on the Rhino, I guess. Another Rhino. That Rhino will come down next turn. Bankbuster is a really strong magic card. Drew me 3 cards and now I have a 1/1 and a 4/4 and a treasure. And it can also just be a 4/4 attacker on turn 3 if you have a 3 power creature to crew it with on turn 3. I mean, this card is just really, really strong. No wonder it's seeing so much play in standard. Looks like I'm out valuing another opponent here with my red green midrange deck. This is really not what I wanted to be doing, but hey, here we are, I suppose. Attack the expert. What? Guess I'll take it. Maybe they have a way to get it back? I don't know. I just want a Kaito. At 14 life. This is 5/4 trample haste. This is 12. I mean, they're not dead. Okay. Looking good, looking good. Interesting deck. I haven't seen it before. Might be kind of decent against Hinata, I guess. If you are like make disappear Disdainful Stroke, and then you have cheap aggressive creatures like Hermit, Ledger Shredder, Expert, Shakedown Heavy, Kaito. That mix could be annoying for a blue-red deck. Rample is gonna take it home. I would choose to deal 2 and 5, not 7, even though I could have dealt 7 to the 2 drop. Thank you for asking. Alright. Okay. Tankbuster looks even better now. As does Burndown. Burndown was kind of clutch. I mean, it wasn't most important card ever in that spot, but it was pretty good. Maybe cut one Titan on a draw. On the expensive side. This is a pretty good hand. Nice red-green mid-range deck. Interesting. Discard this, I think. I like my lands. Ah, do they have Kaito? I'll let him have it. I don't want to abrade the 1/2. Okay. Discarding all my spot removal. If you don't give me any good targets, I don't need it. Make Disappear would certainly make sense in that deck. Okay. I think I might upgrade that one. Oh god. So if I braid this and then let them have the burn down? Play a chariot? I mean, that's okay. Although, I guess the hermit doesn't really do anything. As long as I don't have any spells left in my hand. So maybe I could have just discarded a braid again. But I actually needed to show them two cards there, so I would have needed to show them a braid and burn down. And then they could have chosen one. Hall of Storm Giants, that is a pretty big creature. Everything, what the heck? Swarm of Kittens then. What is this? A meat hook? Probably. Meat hook for 1. Okay. Down to 1 card and a hermit. I am down to nothing for this turn because I'm not gonna use my rebuke on this thing. Okay. Good old fair Magic the Gathering here. Titan. Do I attack now is the question. I don't think so. They smash back for the haul. I'm gonna take 10. I don't like that. Now I'm just gonna take 2. And if I draw lands, I can perhaps cast this Titan. They attack me with the haul. My Warchief will chump, make a Rhino, and I can start popping out Rhinos, which is real nice. I'm gonna blow up this 2/2 flyer and pass the turn back. It even goes to exile, so no Mitok trigger. My opponent seems to have something left, maybe. One last removal spell. Maybe like a power word kill or something. No? Okay. Shield counter. Let me see. I can actually crew in response, put a shield counter on the chariot, make 2 rhinos here. I can blow up this Mitok. Make it 4/4, blow up the Mitok. Pass the turn. It's pretty good too. Ooh. I can crew the chariot and attack with both. They can block the haul on chariot, take 5, go to 17. Then I have 2 4/4s, a 7/7, a 5/3. Seems okay. Yeah, this is pretty good spot. They just pass the turn here. I'll just activate my Den attacker for everything. I'm gonna win that game. They have an underdog, and I suspect they have more here, like maybe a power word kill or something for my Titan. But yeah, there's just no reason to not attack with the Den. Although the reason to not attack with the Den is maybe to just make devils instead. Yeah, this is pretty good. Spell Pierce, I'd like to pay for that. Okay. Everybody will mean good things for me. Yeah, block that, that's fine. You take a bazillion damage. You die, actually? Yeah, you take 18. Okay. This is just... Oh, man, I can't believe it. But yeah, I'm out of time. This is gonna be it for this video. We've played 4 times against just 2-color basic decks. I think we lost multiple game ones. I think 3 out of 4 game ones we lost. And then Osport, my... plan of just turning into a red-green mid-range deck, yeah, was sufficient enough to take it home against these Yeah, I mean, those weren't meta decks, but they were not unplayable either. They had some decent cards. They had plans. Besides maybe the life gain deck, that was definitely not a good deck. In any case, I mean, try it out for yourself if you have the cards. I did try it out a little bit and I had some fun. I really made some players concede very early because I blew up all their lands and they were just had nothing left. Unfortunately, I couldn't really showcase that to you in this video, but I think you get the point. And the nice part about the stack is that if you don't get to Ponza someone, you'd still have this powerful, just all these powerful cards and Fable and Chariot and Titan. And yeah, I guess the one change I could see making would be one Reckoner Bankbuster in for a Shigeki. Shigeki in multiples. I mean, it's fine in multiples, but you don't need, like, three copies is already pretty decent, I think. Yeah, and multiples can get a little clunky. In any case, this was it. This was the standard brew I wanted to show you. A little bit something that maybe you're not used to by me. Let me know how you liked it. If you did like it, leave a like. Leave a subscription if you haven't yet. And for sure, go check out Channel Fireball Pro for deck guides, articles on all types of formats, Magic, and CFP Pro, I write there almost weekly, and there's really great content by some of the greatest Magic minds in the game. And also go check out CFP Marketplace, of course, for any cards you might need. So this is going to be it for me for today. I'm signing off. I'm going to go back to vacation with my family. It was a pleasure. I wish you all a very nice day. Bye-bye. See you soon.